instance, the most common thing that everybody is worrying about and afraid of is what? COVID-19. Is it okay to make dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, "Ya Allah, we ask you to remove the COVID-19 out of this world"? Or because it's an English word, we're not supposed to make in the dua, jama'ah. Right? Of course not. You can make it. You can make that dua. "Ya Allah, we ask you to remove this sickness, this illness from this world." You keep saying that. "Ya Allah, protect me and my family from this illness and this sickness," and so on and so. And specifically, when you realize certain diseases are becoming more common, a plague is coming into a certain area, this is when you start increasing your dua, like ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect you from it, because I don't know if it's going to hit me or not. It could possibly go anywhere. So this dua is very important, that we make the dua inshallah ta'ala, seeking protection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from all kind of diseases. Obviously, the Prophet, like I said, he speaks about specific time, this existed in their time. Some of it might have social implication, like for example, al-baras, which is a leukodermic, for example, when you have a change in your skin, in your appearance, a lot of people might start getting kind of worried about it in terms of the social implication of that. When someone gets, for example, certain allergies that shows on their skin, and as a result, they feel so terrible about going out in public and so on, it's not that it's haram, it's just a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala they're going through. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for them, ya Rabbil Alameen. So you seek refuge with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from falling into a situation like this. Because I might not have the patience for it, subhanAllah. I might not have the patience for that. So I ask Allah to protect me from it. Second thing he says, well, junoon. Junoon, insanity. I think it's obvious why we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from this. Because if someone loses the faculty of mind, Allah musta'an, they become the most vulnerable in all aspects, physically, emotionally, financially, you name it. They can be taken advantage of, unfortunately. So you just ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect your sanity for you, so you always have the aqal and the faculty of the mind by which you make right judgment and right decisions. Wal judam, leprosy. And again, these are specific diseases that are contagious, that definitely has not just social implications, health implications, the psychological, subhanAllah. So you ask Allah to protect you from all of that. And then the last one, he says, وَسَيِّ الْأَسْقَامِ. He said, "Ya Rabbi," as if he's saying, "Ya Allah, these three that I just mentioned, just examples. These are just examples. But I do seek refuge and protection with you from سَيِّ الْأَسْقَامِ," which means what? All kind of diseases, all kind of sicknesses. All of them. Like, you know, Ya Allah, you created them. You know how horrible they can be. And I ask you to protect me from all these horrible and difficult diseases. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us all from this, Ya Rabbil Alameen. We ask Allah to protect us from any disease, Ya Allah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us safe, ourselves, our families, our loved ones. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us safety in our lives, in our bodies, in our minds, in our wealth, Ya Rabbil Alameen. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to protect us from the COVID-19 and all its variations. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to keep us all safe from it, Ya Allah. Ya Rabbi, we know that you are the one who created this disease, and Ya Allah, you create the cure for it. We ask you in this moment that you send down the cure, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Ya Allah, we ask you to remove and alleviate the suffering of those who are going through it, Ya Rabbil Alameen. We ask you, Ya Rahman, Ya Rahim, for those who are ill because of it, that you give them full shifa and full recovery. Recovery that leaves no trace of illness, Ya Rabbil Alameen. Ya Allah, we ask you in this very moment, Ya Rabbil Alameen, that you alleviate the suffering of the world because of this disease. Ya Allah, we ask you to restore our health, to restore the health of this world for us, Ya Allah. Ya Rabbi, we ask you to continue to bless us with your Rahman, your mercy, Ya Rahman, Ya Rahim. Walhamdulillah, wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka nabiyin Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Any question, jama'ah? Yes, go ahead. Okay, so let's repeat the dua, inshallah, quickly in Arabic. Although, again, the words themselves, they're not necessarily important as much as the seeking protection from any disease. So the dua is, Allahumma, inni a'udhu bika min al-baras wal-junoon wal-judham wa sayyi al-asqam. Allahumma, inni a'udhu bika min al-baras والجنون والجذام وسيء الأسقام. اللهم إني أعوذ بك من البرص والجنون والجذام وسيء الأسقام. اللهم آمين. جزاكم الله خير. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. إن شاء الله تعالى the Zakah program will be starting maybe less than 5 minutes.